Hi friends, today we'll know about the pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium. In the name itself, it is indicating pseudo means it is giving a false appearance of multiple layers. So this is called as a pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium, and then it is having two types, ciliated and non-ciliated. Here, this is the basement membrane having a single layer of arrangement of columnar cells at different heights with different position of nuclei will be seen at each cells, but each cell they don't definitely reach the surface epithelium, so that's why the nuclei position is at different in this each cell. Look here, this is the columnar cell having the nuclei at this position, and these are the goblet cells, and these are the another columnar cells having the position of nuclei at different levels. So by the position of this nuclei at different levels, generally for the appearance it will be looks like as stratified layer, so that's why it is known as a pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. And this is the connective tissue, and these are the blood vessels. Here these are the cilia, these are the columnar cells with different nuclear positions. Examples of the pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium is upper respiratory tract, example trachea. Next one is epididymis. Examples for the pseudostratified non-ciliated columnar epithelium is auditory tube, male urethra, and the excretory parts of secretory glands. These are lined by the pseudostratified columnar epithelium. So this is about the pseudostratified columnar epithelium. This is the next slide. Transitional epithelium, otherwise it is also called as an urothelium. This kind of epithelium mainly lines the hollow organs. Now we'll see the each layers in the transitional epithelium. In this epithelium, the chief character is it shape of the cells will varies depending upon the contraction and relaxation of the muscle. In the relaxation state, we'll see number of layers. This is the relaxed position. In the relaxed position, first layer is, this is the basal cell layer, which is seen on the basement membrane. This is the basal cell layer. And above this basal cell layer, we'll see the intermediate polyhedral cells will be there. The shape of the cells in the basal cell layer is low columnar or cuboidal. Mainly cuboidal or columnar will be seen on the basal cell layer. In the middle cells are intermediate cells are polyhedral cells. The superficial top cells are umbrella shaped cells. Umbrella apical cells, which are facing towards the luminal surface, are umbrella shaped. These are thick. So the apical cells are very thick and umbrella shaped. So this will be this is the state which is seen in the relaxed condition. In the contraction condition, whereas in the contraction state, the basal cell layer is made up of two layers, that is the cuboidal or columnar, and the superficial cells, that is made up of a squamous. Mostly the cells are flat and squamous in appearance. So the appearance of the epithelium in the contraction state is like stratified squamous epithelium, whereas in the relaxed state the appearance is like a stratified squamous cuboidal epithelium. So this is about the transitional epithelium. If you see the examples of the transitional epithelium, it lines the renal calyces, renal pelvis, and ureter, urinary bladder, part of urethra. But the variations in the shape of the cells will be seen in the urinary bladder only. This is about the transitional epithelium.
Thank you, friends. A lot of effort is involved in preparing these videos. A small subscribe from your side will motivate me to do more videos. Please do subscribe to my channel. To subscribe, please click on the subscribe button below the video.